The previous class we were discussing about one of the major initiative initiated by the government of India at pan national level, and it was fully centrally funded project, that is Operation Blackboard. Okay. And we have seen already that Operation Blackboard was launched in the year 1987, just after the National Policy of Education 1986 to universalize elementary education. So that was the main motto of launching Operation Blackboard throughout the country. Basically, we have seen that this Operation Blackboard talks about providing a minimum set of facility at primary school level throughout the country. However, the name says that Operation Blackboard, which literally means that it is only providing a blackboard and the writing facility. But in fact, when we see the objectives of this policy, you will find that it was not only not like that, it was focused for providing the blackboard facility to the students or in the school. Moreover, it talks about providing the necessary basic facility in the school that is required. So, this policy was focused on that thing. Next, we had also seen that this Operation Blackboard policy of this program talks about almost all the areas related to the qualitative and quantitative improvement in the elementary education. Let it be providing a infrastructural facility, let it be providing the human resources, let it be providing the teaching learning resources and the other things. It talks about all the things that are very much required and essential for qualitative and quantitative improvement in the area of elementary education. Okay. And more specifically, when we see that after implementing this policy for several years, the policy was revised based upon the feedback received from the ground level. Because once the policy was framed and then it was implemented in the 1987, it was launched, and then based upon the feedback that was received from the field, it was revised. And the revised policy says that there should be continuous of ongoing support to the area, especially those who are dominated by SC and ST, scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. Why it was talking like that? When you will see the policy document, I will share the policy document to you also. Just now. So, why this policy document says to continue the Operation Blackboard to the SC and ST area? Because at that time, the educational attainment throughout the country was not so good. Education level, the people were not sensitized, and due to all those hurdles, education was not reaching to those areas where SC and ST population was there. So, whatever the government has done, whatever the government has initiated with Operation Blackboard, it was not reaching to those area. However, to other area, the progress was quite satisfactory. So, government thought that it should be continued to those areas. And it also talks about that the scope of Operation Blackboard should be expanded, because in the first part it was talking about the qualitative and quantitative improvement, and it was also talking about the making available the infrastructure and the teaching learning material, but somehow it was not very clear about the how much teachers should be appointed in a primary school. They were talking that the human resources should be given, but it was not very much clear that how many teachers, what should be the teacher student ratio should be there. However, this document doesn't talks about the teacher student ratio, because that time the financial status of the country and other thing was also not much favorable. So, recruiting so many human resource and spending money on the salary was also not feasible at that time. But it talks in the revised one that at least 3 teachers and 3 rooms should be there. These 2 things are very mandatory: minimum 3 teachers and minimum 3 rooms. Every primary school must have. However, we know that after this, even most of the school we are not having 3 rooms and 3 teachers in each school. That's why later on we launched DPEP program, DPEP 1, DPEP 2, DPEP 3, then SSA came. So all those program were launched, because even the Operation Blackboard was not able to provide all those things. But it talks about that minimum 3 teachers and 3 rooms should be there in primary school. It also talks that the Operation Blackboard can also be expanded to the upper primary level. Okay, upper primary level, that is the 6 to 8, to provide at least 1 room for each class, like that 6, 7, 8. There should be a headmaster come office room. At least minimum facility should be there in the upper primary level. It also talks about that there must be a toilet facility for boys and girls, separate toilet and working toilet facility must be there for the boys and girls, and essential learning equipment must be there. Okay, so these things the revised policy talks about, and it says that it must be expanded to the upper primary level. In order to implement, because they have given certain recommendations, but how those recommendations will be implemented, because it talks about that there will be office, there will be teaching learning material, and within the teaching learning material in the detail we will see also what kind of a thing it talks about. So, teacher also needs to be trained in using those materials, because if the teachers are not trained, then whatever the material, whatever the facilities we will be providing, that will be worthless. It does not have any worth, it does not have any values. So, that is why this document talks that not only the human resources will be recruited, not only the facilities will be enhanced, but there will be also a component of teacher training on how to use those materials, learning material, teaching material, for the teaching learning purpose. Even as I have told that this program was a centrally sponsored program. Centrally sponsored program it was, but we know that after using the equipment, whatever the equipment will be provided by the government, after using the equipment for some time, it may become non-functional or it may require a repairing or a replacement. So this document says that for those things, a state government should take some burden, because it will be more burden for the central government. However, it provides enough flexibility in the teaching learning material relevant to the curriculum and the local needs, means as per the need and requirement, as per the local context, you can procure the materials. One more very important thing that it document talks about for the qualitative improvement, that whatever the teachers will be recruited, because it talks about that in every school minimum 3 teachers and 3 rooms will be there. So whatever the teacher will be recruited, so 50% of them will be female teachers. See, now we used to talk about the reservation for women and all those things, but this document at that time it was talking the 50% seat must be reserved for the women candidate. Okay, and again important thing is that, like I think yesterday also it was coming in our mind, that micro planning and to take the project means the micro planning component. So this policy document talks that in order to provide all the facilities, in order to enhance the quality of the elementary education in the elementary schools, a macro level planning is required. Why this micro level planning? Because the context, locality, socio cultural practices, religious practices, the community belief is a different throughout the country. And when we are trying to work for the education, in the education setup, we must consider all those things, because without considering it is a very difficult to work for the qualitative and a quantitative improvement in the education. It is a very difficult, and we know all those things, that importance of psychological part, sociological part, cultural part, and their implication in teaching learning purpose. We know all those things very well, that's why I'm not discussing that in detail. But how those things will be incorporated, in order to understand, a micro level planning is very much required. Micro level planning means a person will visit the locality and they will try to understand the need and necessity of the local that locality. What is the need and necessity? What kind of education is required? And they will also understand the cultural practices, socio-cultural practices. What are their religious and cultural beliefs? so that when the teacher will be teaching in the class, they will be engaging the learner in the learning situation, they will keep in mind all those things, they will incorporate all those things. And if they will incorporate all those things, then only the teaching learning process will be qualitative. So the micro level planning says that they have to understand the society, locality, everything. And in the micro level planning, they will collect the data, they will visit, they will observe, and they will document it, that what kind of teaching learning methodology, pedagogical process will work here, even what kind of example will be suitable for those students. Because we know that the examples, pedagogical process, it is very much dependent on the socio-cultural practices, the belief, the status of the child. So the micro level planning is very much emphasized here. Okay, so we will stop here for a small question answer session, and then we will go to the next part of this Operation Blackboard. Anybody who have a question? Nobody? You don't have any question? So, shall I proceed further? Okay, so I think you don't have any question. Shall I go further?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir,
as I have told in the very first part of the discussion, that Operation Blackboard program was launched for the qualitative and quantitative improvement. Okay, so if I am saying that the quantitative and a qualitative improvement, it will have a two part. Obviously, quantitative means making available elementary education to the each and every child, means reaching out the elementary education. Then again, if I am telling that is for the qualitative improvement, so how the quality will improve? For improving the quality, you have to improve the infrastructure, you have to improve the human resources, means recruitment and training, you have to provide the teaching learning materials, okay, and you have to improve the facilities in the school premises. These are the things by which we can enhance the क्वालिटी है ना, क्वालिटी ऑफ एलिमेंटरी एजुकेशन. सो आई थिंक इन माय
ऑल दोस थिंग्स आर नॉट एम्फसाइज्ड इन एनईपी 1986 एम्फसाइज्ड इन एनईपी 1986
ओके सी when we talk about the policy and when we talk about the program, both are the different thing. And when you will see the program, it will have a detailed outline that how it will be achieved. But when you will see the policy, it will set out the goal that what they want to do. The program means how, what kind of a program will be initiated. That may not be a part of a policy. Policy talks about, and it is framed actually on the basis that what is the ground level reality. So 86 talks about the ground level reality of elementary education is not satisfactory. And it needs to strengthen. Then how it will be strengthened? For strengthening the program will come. This is the one thing. Second thing, you may say that if the policy will only talk about that what is there and what needs to be done, and it will not say that how it will be done, then policy may fail. You may have a question, and your question is valid. That's why after 86 we have brought a revised policy in 1992, and together with the revision of the policy, government introduced program of action. So it's true that all those things is not written in the policy, because policy is a different thing, programs are the different thing. How the policy will be transacted, implemented, for implementing the policy there is a program. So policy talks that the condition of elementary education in the country is not satisfactory, it needs to be strengthened. For a strengthening, Blackboard scheme, Blackboard program was launched. So it's quite clear.
Yes sir, yes sir.
Okay,
thank you very
much. Umakant?
yes sir thank you very much sir.
So I think so many time I have emphasized also that the failure behind the policy 86, first it was not talking about the program of action, means how it will be. You are saying that okay, I want to improve the status of elementary education or whatever, so many thing is talked in that policy, but how it will happen. So for that shortcoming, the revised one was brought. Revised one doesn't have any meaning, because the policy was prepared in the 86 and we were bringing the program of action in 92, after realizing that without a program of action we cannot proceed. So government thought, okay, so since we are bringing program of action, so and during this almost 6 years is passed, so let we do some minor revision also. So that was a minor revision in the policy. That's why we don't know NEP 1992, because if it has a major revision, then it will come as a separate policy. But it was not having a major revision, it was having a minor revision. It was having a minor revision, just like a book. When we do a minor revision in a book, we bring a edition, first edition, second edition, third edition. If you have to do a major revision, then we discontinue that and we bring a new book. So it is like that. And for quantitative and a qualitative, all thing. Till here I have discussed in a very brief, because if we start discussing in detail, it will take a very much time, a long time. the original document, that is a guideline for implementing Operation Blackboard, is of a 75 page that I have shared in the WhatsApp group just now. It is of a 75 page. So, if I will start explaining 75 pages, it will take a time. So, I have given you so that you can go through that also. And in brief, I have covered that it talks about the human resources, it talks about the infrastructure, it talks about the teaching learning materials, it talks about the facilities. Like then when we talk about the qualitative improvement, so without providing safe campus, how we can expect that a student will feel safe and they will attend the school? Because for the quality, attending school is one of the major important thing. Whatever the thing you are doing, if a student is not attending the school and not learning, then all whatever you have did, it is totally waste. It does not mean anything actually. So, for girls, the facilities of toilet and a safe environment is very much required. For the people who are unreached, like a population where SC and STs are there, they need special attention. Even the people who are a primitive tribe, they don't stay at a place. They used to roam here and there. So, how we can provide educational opportunity to them? That also needs a special attention. Those who can be approached, it is very easy to provide education to them. Suppose that my children or a children in your house, it is very easy to provide education to them. Only I have to work for the school. You will send the child and then they will get education. But those who are primitive tribe, it is very difficult. And I was talking to one of my friend who is from the Himachal Pradesh. Okay, so in the Himachal, there are two type of geographical location. One is the hilly area, and people used to live in the hills also. And one is the plain, that is the field area. People also used to live. So those who are living in the field, it is very easy to provide education. Open the school and little bit sensitize, and you do, and the student will attend the school. But those who are at a hilly place, it is a difficult, because during the summer time, means when the snowfall is not happening, they used to live in at a hills, and when the sun snowfall will start, they will come down from the hill. So 3-4-5 months they will not be at their own place. Children will be dislocated. It's difficult for them. So government had opened two school for them. One is at a hilly place where they are originally staying, and one is in the field area where they will come during the snowfalls. It's a challenge. You might have seen that in the outskirt of the town, there are some people staying in the tents, and they used to move from here to there. So how you will educate them? Actually, this was the challenge, and this is still a challenge. Okay, so let it be. The discussion will go so long. So just wait 1 minute, I will share that and then I will continue the discussion. Okay, so till now we have seen that Operation Blackboard talks about the qualitative and quantitative improvement. These two things the Operation Blackboard talks. So, if and within that we have also seen that for this it talks that improving infrastructural facility, teaching learning resources, then the human resources, then the other facilities, it talks about. But again a point comes that if I am talking about the teaching learning equipments, or if I am talking about the facilities, or if I am talking about the recruitment of a teacher, what should be the criteria, how this thing will be procured, or the human resources will be recruited, how this thing will happen, what should be the criteria for all those things. So, for making a criteria, the work was given to the NCERT, and NCERT, they have developed a policy document in 1988. They have developed that in the 1986, the policy was launched. 87, Blackboard operation was launched, and in 88 that guideline came, which talks about what should be the specification criteria for all those things. And the same document I have shared with you, it's entitled as Operation Blackboard Essential Facilities at Primary Stage Norms and Specification. It was developed by the NCERT and a Bureau of Indian Standard, BIS. You must be knowing that it is the organization which controls the quality parameter, quality control work it does. And they have developed the document which talks in very detail about everything. Like that I was talking about the materials, like that the teacher's manual, textbooks, syllabus, what kind of a syllabus should be there, what should be there in the syllabus, how much quantity of a syllabus must be available, like that everything it talks about. It talks about even the textbook, what kind of a quality of a textbook should be there. You must have done an exercise during your B.Ed times. The quality means evaluation of a textbook. I think it must be in your syllabus during B.Ed. How you will assess that the textbook which is there is quality textbook? That also it talks about. Even it talks about the number of textbook that must be available there.